production of electrochemical cell, right? What have we discussed so far in electrochemistry? We have discussed about electrode potential, half cell also we have discussed, how potential develops, and the decrease in Gibbs-free energy is nothing but the energy that we are utilizing, right? Delta. Electrochemical cell is what? A spontaneous reaction, right? There is a spontaneous reaction. Anode is positively charged or negatively charged? Negatively charged. Electrochemical cell, anode is negatively charged. In electrolytic cell, anode is positively charged. So we will discuss after this. Okay, so electrochemical cell construction. So what we need for the construction of electrochemical cell? We need two half cells first, right? So the diagram we have here, we will take one Zn electrode or zinc half cell. And the other one is what? The other one is copper. Which one acts at anode and which one acts at cathode? Zinc or copper?
Zinc is anode.
Why? What is the electrode potential of zinc?
Minus 0.76.
And for copper it is 0.34. So the more electrode potential, reduction will be easier. That's what we have already discussed, right? So when you take zinc, and copper, so zinc will behave as anode, right? And that's why zinc we have to write the zinc electrode or zinc half cell or anodic half cell will always write on the left side. Okay? So this is zinc electrode or zinc rod we can say. Right? When zinc rod we are taking, what is the electrolyte here? The electrolyte must contain Zn plus 2 ion, right? That's the condition of half cell, right? The metal must be placed in the solution of its own ion. So when zinc rod we are taking, the solution must be what? ZnSO4. Aqueous ZnSO4. In the solution must contain Zn plus 2 ion. That's the constraint we have. Similarly, here we have copper electrode. This is copper rod. And the electrolyte is what? Electrolyte must contain Cu plus 2 ion, right? So electrolyte we are taking here is aqueous CuSO4. Okay? So after some time what happens? Since it is the anode half cell we have, so there is oxidation takes place. So Zn will convert into Zn plus 2 aqueous and releases 2 electron. This is Zn solid. Right? So this rod becomes what? Negatively charged. Because Zn plus 2 is coming into the solution. So in the solution, the concentration of Zn plus 2 ion increases, right? Initially what happens when we have ZnSO4 initially present, the concentration of Zn plus 2 is equal to the concentration of SO4 2 minus. The solution is neutral initial, right? But when the reaction, when you dip this electrode into this solution, then this electrode releases Zn plus 2 ion. So obviously the concentration of Zn plus 2 ion in the solution increases. So now the solution is not electrically neutral, it is positively charged, right? Similarly, here what happens? Copper Cu plus 2 in the solution takes 2 electron, this is copper aqueous, and converts into Cu solid. Okay? This Cu2 plus ion deposited onto the electrode and the rod becomes what? Positively charged. Right? When you connect this electrode, this 2 electrode, with an external source of external wire, conducting wire, then there will be what? Right, the current flows from negative rod to, sorry, the electron flows from negative rod to positive rod, right? So the direction of currents will be what? From anode to, this is anode, right? And this is cathode. We always write or draw anode half cell on the left hand side, it is the convention, right? So this direction represents what? The flow of electrons. Because the negative electrode has more electrons, obviously the electron flows from negative rod to positive rod. So what is the direction of current then? Current flows in opposite direction, I, right? So direction of electron is anode to cathode, write down. Direction of electron from anode to cathode, you can also write it as from negative rod to positive rod. Okay, direction of current will be reversed from cathode to anode. This question also they asked in the exam. And construction of electrochemical cell, they have asked many times in board exam. Yes, also important. Right. Now what happens? Initially the current starts flowing in these two electrodes, but the circuit is not complete. Right? These two are connected, but the circuit is not complete, right? This is one reason why after some time the cell stops working. Okay, for second reason is what? When this rod is negatively charged, so around this rod what we have? Positive charge. This positive charge I am drawing here to make you understand. When this question they ask in exam, don't draw this positive charge. Okay, so this positive charge, because this positive charge, this will attract the electron from this electrode. Right? And similarly here the solution becomes what? Negatively charged. Right? And this negative charge will also repel the electron that is coming from this electrode to that electrode. Right? So after some time what happens? The flow of electron will be difficult, right? And hence the cell stops working. The electron does not flow and hence the current also will not. Right? So this is the drawback, or this was the problem with initially with the electrochemical cell. Now to overcome this problem, what we use? We use U-shaped inverted tube, and this we call it as what? Salt bridge. Salt bridge is what? It is a U-shaped inverted tube in which there is some electrolyte present in semi-liquid form or semi-solid form. Right? Now, in this electrolyte, you can use many different electrolyte, KCl and H4NO3. Suppose I am using KCl here, so KCl is K plus and Cl minus. Remember this end is open, it is not closed. This end is also open, it is not closed. Right? The electrolyte that we are using in solid bridge, it is in semi-liquid form. It cannot flow, right? Like you can see the paste material kind of thing is there. So whenever, what is the purpose of this? Whenever one positive charge develops over here, right? If we neutralize this positive charge and this negative charge, then the neutrality of these two half cells will be maintained and the electron continuously flow. Now the purpose is to what? To neutralize this positive and negative charge. And for that purpose we are using this solid bridge in which an electrolyte is present. Right? So whenever one positive charge forms into this particular half cell, anodic half cell, the Cl- moves from this U-shaped tube and comes into the solution and will neutralize this positive charge over here. So this negative charge will neutralize this positive charge, and hence this positive charge will also go there and neutralize this negative charge into this half cell. Right? So when the charge will get neutralized, it means the electrical neutrality will be maintained and hence the current continues to flow. Understood? This is the purpose of salt bridge. Right? There are 2-3 conditions for the electrolyte we use in salt bridge. We discussed that. Okay, so two things which is important over here, construction of electrochemical cell is important. They specifically ask this question also, what is the function and importance of salt bridge in the exam? Right? So this is the diagram of electrochemical cell. Now you see, this is anode, right? This, since it is present on the left side, we call it as left half cell. Anode present on the left side, we call it as left right? Actually, anode what happens? Oxidation takes place. So we also call it as what? Oxidation half cell. Since it is anode, hence you also call it as anode half cell or anodic half cell. Right? Anode is negatively charged, so you also call it as what? Negative half cell. All these are same thing, all these names are same thing. Okay? So you have to memorize this. So how do you memorize it? You have to memorize this particular term. Right? NOAN. Left half cell, oxidation takes place. Where oxidation takes place, you call it as anode half cell. And anode half cell is negative. Just reverse of this will be what? The other one, right? It is left, so it is right half cell, reduction half cell, cathode half cell, and positive half cell. Just reverse of this. So when you keep this in mind, NOAN, reverse of that will be what? The cathode. Copy down this. Right on next. In the construction of electrochemical cells, oxidation half cell. Oxidation half cell is always placed. Oxidation half cell is always placed on the left side. Reaction you have written, reaction of anode, reaction of anode. One more thing we mentioned here. Since this Zn solid is converting into Zn plus 2 aqueous, the weight of this rod will decrease or increase? Decrease. The weight of anode rod decreases. Similarly, here the copper is getting deposited on the electrode, the weight of cathode rod increases. Right? Next slide down. Right on salt bridge, its function and importance. Salt bridge, its function and importance. It is an inverted U-shaped cube. It is an inverted U-shaped cube which contains an inert electrolyte. Like KCS. KCL, KNO3, NH4Cl. NH4Cl, etc. In agar powder. We mix this powder to make it semilip. Okay, in agar powder. In bracket you write down in semi-liquid state. In semi-liquid state. Right on the end of salt bridge is open. The end of the salt bridge is open. So that the ions of electrolyte can move easily into the half cell. Next slide. It completes the circuit by maintaining the flow of electrons containing the flow of electron. Next line. It maintains the electrical neutrality of the solution. It maintains the electrical neutrality of the solution. Third point, it minimizes the liquid junction potential. Okay. This potential, you see this negative and positive charge. Since this positive charge is getting neutralized, this difference, potential difference, is getting minimized. That's what it means. Right?